Okay. Pagi-pagi belum lagi cuti. Libur sekolah kita belajar di kelas-kelas lagi ya, Mas ya. Okay, can you share your screen? Oh ya, kita pakai bahasa Indonesia aja deh. Coba pakai bahasa Indonesia aja. Kalau tadi malam kita pakai bahasa Inggris, kita sekarang pakai bahasa Indonesia coba ya. Oke, lanjut ini ya, Mr. Judge ya. Don't judge.me. Tadi Mas Tee sudah ngerjain satu soal di situ kan. Lunchbox ya. Lunchbox ini code-nya masih kelihatan tuh. Jadi lunchbox, kamu punya, kamu kayak catering gitu ya. Catering punya N lunchboxes gitu. N nasi kotak. Terus kemudian ada daftar sekolah yang perlu nasi kotak sekian buah, sekian biji untuk siswa-siswanya. Nah, dari daftar sekolah itu kamu mau memaksimalkan jumlah sekolah yang bisa dikasih lunchbox. Nah, gimana caranya? Nah, logiknya, algoritmanya adalah greedy. Greedy algorithm ya. Jadi kamu ambil sekolah yang perlu lunchbox-nya paling sedikit dulu, terus kamu kasih. Oke, satu sekolah. Terus cari yang kemudian, yang paling sedikit yang kemudian terus kamu kasih. Dua sekolah dan seterusnya gitu kan. Sampai lunchbox-nya hampir habis. Nah, paling terakhir pastikan kamu punya sisa lunchbox itu cukup untuk sekolah yang terakhir yang kamu bisa kasih gitu kan. Nah, itu tadi Mas Duis salah logiknya di situ ya. Tadi Mas Duis nggak ngecek. Tadi Mas Duis cuma ngecek apakah masih punya sisa nasi. Nah, itu tapi itu salah karena sekolahnya harus dikasih semuanya. Maksudnya apa? Siswa di sekolah itu harus dapat semuanya. Kalau nggak punya cukup ya udah nggak ngasih, berarti nasinya sisa gitu. Nah, tadi mesti salah di situ terus kita koreksi. Oke. Okay. Next problem. Soal selanjutnya.
Oke.
Potato ya, bobotnya potato, kentang. Jadi ada N buah kentang. D itu apa ya, D? What is D?
D is the number of days until the competition.
Oh, it's a mashed potato competition, okay. Oh, ini greedy juga ya, you need to maximize ya. Ini greedy juga ya, okay, got it. So every day you can process the mashed potato ya, according to the maximum. Okay. That's why in 2 days in the input sample 9 1 4 12 the maxim yang paling maksimal kalau cuma bisa 2 kali ya ambil 12 sama 9 kan, 12 sama 9 jadi 21, makanya jawabannya 21. Okay, this is greedy algorithm also. So it should be very straightforward, should be very easy for you. Yeah, include factor and okay, good. I'm ambil copy dulu. Oke, jadi yang mesti saya lakukan, ambil inputnya, ditaruh di vektor, push to vektor, and then sort. Terus kemudian sort ya, mengurutkan vektornya. Ya, yeah, semicolon. The problem with Python coder ya. Kalau di Python nggak ada semicolon, so you are not accustomed to it. Kamu nggak kebiasaan ngasih semicolon. Oke, okay. Good. Looks correct. Wait. No. Eh? Yes. Oh ya, yeah, ya, yeah, ya. Yeah. Correct. Because, okay, got it. You do it for apa? For loopnya sampai D aja ya. So number of days aja ya. Dan udah sorted ya. How do you sort this? Oh, I ada optionnya ya.
Oh. Apa itu? Wrong.
You can see the sort option. Greater ya. What is that? Is it really sort descending? Greater itu sort descending ya. Because another way you can do adalah you keep the sort as usual.
Then you reverse.
For loop ya, yeah, reverse. Your for loop is a reverse.
Oh, reverse. Oh, okay.
Start from you start I equal to n, yeah.
I equal to b. Oh no, d minus 1.
Not d, right?
Yeah, d minus 1.
Oh yeah. Oh, he has a set of n potatoes, mas. N-nya, you haven't used n at all. Ini same problem like before.
I did. I did.
Wait, itu line of apa itu? Oh, n integers ya. Then your for loop itu bukan d dong. For loopnya n dong.
Why?
Your for loop n, but you have to do it d times. Your for loop starts from n because the length of your vector itu n kan?
Yeah.
The length of your vector itu n. You start at the end of the vector, right? At the very end of the vector, itu kan yang paling gede kan? Yang paling gede, yang terakhir kan?
Oh ya?
N minus 1 toh? N minus 1, you start from N minus 1. N minus 1, and then you make sure, yes, correct. Yes, that is correct. Okay, now why is it wrong?
It's including 4.
It's including 4. So that means apa? Oh, you add minus 1 sekarang ya. Okay. You could also why you add minus 1? It's just n minus d, right? Yeah, correct. Because you use greater than or equal, yeah. So it's just until n minus d aja. Okay, coba submit. Kalau salah I have an idea what you miss.
Ah.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Okay, so it's not really a problem, okay?
There is one. Okay.
Tapi baru tahu itu sort bisa pakai greater gitu ya. You want to reverse back? That means your mistake tadi apa ya? That means what was your mistake ya? Yang greater tadi. Kenapa tadi salah yang greater? Is that how you sort? Coba Google. Sort descending ya, Pak. Sort vector C++ descending, yes. Yeah. How to sort a vector in descending order? Oh ya, greater ya, betul ya. Tadi kenapa salah ya kalau gitu ya?
No.
Can we see your previous code? When you submit, are you able to see your previous code? Di Mr. Chess bisa nggak? Di Mr. Chess nggak bisa ya? Can you see your submitted code?
My submitted code? Potato, salad, my submission.
Nah, yang salah, tadi view source itu ya. Coba kita lihat. View begin, view end, greater int, for int I that looks correct, no? Oh, you haven't initialized t. You haven't initialized t, Mas.
This one also didn't initialize t.
I don't know, maybe you got lucky or something. Coba, just copy paste this whole code. Copy paste the whole code. Just copy paste aja and replace your code. Coba.
What? Okay.
Yeah. Now test and submit. Already test ya? Yeah? Okay. Have you tested the test case? In your have you tested? Just to be sure. Okay. Now submit. So your bug, bugnya tadi ini lupa nggak initialize t dulu. Seharusnya should be correct. Yeah, just because you forgot to, a very simple bug, initialize to zero ya. Yeah. Actually kalau di Python, no actually in Python, yeah you never have to declare right. So the first time you introduce,
no you have to.
Mas Joe ini bisa aja ini Google, Google, or two jadi resources doang ya. But ada komen Mas, ada komen masuk dari Mas Joe. Apa? Parents itu orang tua itu cuman resources aja buat anak-anak ya. Lebih sering tanya Google. Tapi itu memang benar banget itu. Kalau di sini kalau nanya ayah, kenapa apa? Kenapa what is the largest whale atau apa gitu kan? Oh, kenapa chicken pox dikasih nama chicken pox gitu kemarin ya? Apa hubungannya sama chicken gitu kan? Saya enggak tahu langsung, "Hey Google," gitu. Yang ditanya Google. It's okay, ayo. Let's continue. Bisa. So ini Mas Joy. Ayo next. Aku boleh jadi ngakak, enggak bisa serius. Aduh udah. Aduh terlanjur mau.
Aduh. The claim is isn't cut from the library. We need to borrow a project from him. He also was not interested to cut it. Ini guys, what is going to submit to the library and this input is one into Japan. The length of the sentence will be less than or equal to 1,000. This is easy. You just use getline. Aya, I can't hear you. Oh, okay.
Mana Mas?
No, I know how to do this.
Oh, you just need to repeat itu ya. Kayak Bart Simpson ya. I will not forget to claim my easy link.
In and get line.
Getline is very useful, yeah.
Yes. Int I for 0, I smaller than n, I for 4. Yep.
Good.
Okay, there's no test case.
Extra space mungkin? Do you have extra space
what
in your in your input after again in your input? No, in your input test case.
Yeah.
In your test case in, you have not C out. Wait. I don't get this. Oh, I know why, Mas. Okay, so what actually happened when you do C in to N, line 7 itu. So, ketika kamu C in N, itu dia baca 5, kan? Dia baca 5 and dia berhenti di situ. It stops there. Well, actually in that line, there is one more character left, right? What is it?
Enter.
Yes, new line. Jadi ketika kamu get line, I'm not sure if it works. I think what you should do just get line juga aja. No, because C in itu untuk masukin ke variable kan? Yeah. Coba mau nggak dia? Kalau kayak gitu mau nggak? Nggak mau ya? Nggak mau karena n itu integer, jadi get line itu harus string terus kamu pakai s aja, s terus kemudian nanti s pakai string to integer gitu, stoi.
Stoi, I don't know how to do stoi.
Just write stoi lah, yeah. Or Google stoi. No. You need to convert it to integer, right? Yeah. So you still need that. Use s to get line. Yeah, and then stoi from, yeah. So n equal to stoi gitu kan? Yeah, stoi C++. STOI, yeah, STOI give the string and then the integer, that's it. So STOI S, N, udah gitu aja. That's all the syntax.
S, N. Oh, okay.
Kalau di Python kan kamu nulisnya kan n equal to, doesn't work that way, is it? Wait. No. Itu n equal to stoi, Mas. N equal to stoi s. I think maybe let ya, yeah, coba gitu, mau nggak? Ya, yeah, it works ya.
It works. Why would they make it?
Oh ya, yeah. Ya. Yeah? So here apa kamu yang hal yang baru yang kamu pelajari itu C in. C in itu sebuah stream. Stream, you know stream?
No.
Like river stream or wind stream gitu. So something that is flowing.
Oh, nah, ya.
So in this case is a stream of characters. Jadi aliran karakter. So in the input, imagine inputnya kan file kan? It's actually like a sequence of character kan. Jadi the first character, the second character, and then new line is also character. I move to the next line, and then character. So it's like a stream of characters. It's a serial stream of character, one by one character. So when you see in, it will process until the character that you need to process aja gitu. Nah, so in this case when you use C in N yang tadi ya, C in N, there is one more character that was not processed, which is a new line character. Okay, so these are the small things yang apa ya? Kalau Python itu enggak ribet. Python nggak ribet at all kan? In Python, kalau di Python you just need to do in input udah selesai, in input aja udah selesai. Tapi kalau C++ you need to be very careful karena C++ itu lebih apa ya istilahnya bare metal gitu. Dia lebih low level ketimbang Python. Jadi banyak hal yang sangat detail yang kamu harus hati-hati. Okay, good. You learn something new.
Stoi
dan get line apa? Yang paling penting sebenarnya stream tadi, Mas. You need to remember that. when you do see in, it doesn't read the, it only reads until the necessary digit aja. That means it doesn't read the new character, new line character. This looks fun. Okay, this looks fun. This is maybe the first time you pertama kalinya kamu ketemu graf kayaknya. Adjacency matrix.
What's bidirectional?
Bidirectional means ini, if you have two nodes A and B gitu ya, node A and node B. A pointing to B one direction kan? B pointing to A one direction. So if it can points both directions, that means it's bidirectional. So that means if you connect A and B, jadi kayak misalnya let's say A itu city, A and B nodes adalah city, terus connection-nya itu atau edge-nya itu jalan raya gitu, road. So Bukit Batok, Bukit Timah, Bukit Batok and Bukit Timah, there is a road connecting it. So it's a bidirectional road. If just by one connection, kamu cuma perlu satu connection aja, you can go both ways. Itu bidirectional. Tapi kalau itu one way road gitu misalnya, one way road kayak depan rumah kita itu kan one way terus across it one way juga kan. Nah, imagine if it is blocked gitu. Kalau ditutup misalnya ada repair work, let's say, or ada accident gitu, it's blocked. Nah, berarti kan it's only connected one way. So it's unidirectional gitu. It's not bidirectional. You understand?
Yeah.
Yeah. So basically in this example ya, kalau inputnya kan bilangnya 1, 2. That means 1 and 2 is connected. And you don't need to see 2, 1 to know that 2 is also connected to 1. So 1, 2 and 2, 1 is the same, and then you just need to see it once aja. Just 1, 2 aja, you don't need 2, 1.
Where is 1 and where is 2? What is 1 and what is 2?
It's just number, right? The node. So imagine kayak 1 itu Bukit Batok, 2 itu Bukit Timah, 3 itu Bukit Merah, 4 itu Jurong West, 5 itu Jurong East. Just imagine like that. So like different nodes. Okay. Adjacency matrix itu just like the name says, yeah, you can implement using array or vector. So let's say if you use array, for example, so what you need is a two-dimensional array. Jadi imagine you have array of array. So kayak itu yang di bawah itu outputnya kan 0 1 1 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 gitu ya. So in Python you will do that as a list of list, right?
Yeah, list of list.
Yeah, so the same thing, array of array. The only difference is because in C++, if you use array, the length has to be fixed. So you need to take what is the maximum possible input and make it maksimal berapa itu inputnya, dan itu jadikan panjangnya array gitu.
Isn't it n?
Is in n sama m ya? Coba scroll up a bit. N sama sorry, you're right. It's n. Sorry, what am I talking about? It is always n to n, right? Yeah, n to n. Nah, so this matrix, right? What you need to do is to set the array element to 1 if the two numbers are connected.
But how do you know what the number is?
You get from the input, right? Like 1, 2. Okay, that means you need to set from 1 and 2. You set to 1. From 2 to 1, you set to 1 juga.
But how do you know where 1 and 2 is?
That is your ini kan index of your array.
For all arrays.
Yeah. Oke, okay, list of list atau array of array kamu paham ya?
Iya.
Oke. Okay. Nah, imagine that every single list is actually one row in your output itu.
Hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
Terus you see the first number one here. You see the first number one. Itu kan it says that node 1 is connected to node 2.
Yeah.
Yeah, kan? And then the next number 1 is node 1 is also connected to node 3. And then the next one is node 1 is also connected to 4. Right? According to the input, you see? And then finally, node 1 is also connected to 5. Then you do the same thing for the column because the column, you see the first column there, is also 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, right?
Yeah.
Node 2 is connected to 1. Node 3 is connected to 1. Node 4 is connected to 1. Node 5 is connected to 1. Remember, because it's two ways, right? It's bidirectional. If you connect A to B, that means you connect B to A also.
I don't understand for the second.
The second part?
Hmm.
Okay. One sama two di situ, understand ya, one is connected to two.
Yeah.
Now, it also means two is connected to one. That means in the adjacency matrix, you need to set two places, two cells over there. You need to set it to one, that it is connected, right? And that two cells is 1,2 and 2,1, right? Row 1, 2, and row 2, column 1.
Oh.
Get it?
Oh, row 1, okay, now I understand.
Yeah, that's why if you look at the output, the adjacency matrix is always symmetrical by the diagonal. You look at the diagonal yang 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 itu. It is 0 because 1 and 1, you know, you don't connect 1 and 1. 1 is the same as 1, right? 2 and 2 is also you don't connect. So that's why it's always 0. You see the diagonal, the main diagonal there is all 0, right?
Yeah.
And then it's a mirror. The rest is a symmetric, right? It's a mirror.
Yeah. Because,
yeah. When A is connected to B, that means B is also connected to A.
But what? Why is the diagonal not? Why is the diagonal not connected?
Because the diagonal means node 1 and node 1, node 2 and node 2, right? Node 3 and node 3. It's the same node, so you don't add a root for the same node. You don't need to connect the same node, right?
Oh, okay, I understand.
Okay. Very good.
I have to create the array.
So you can call it A, right? Okay, or ADJ. I think ADJ, ADJ is a good. Okay, you can matrix the matrix, yeah. Is matrix a keyword? Yeah. Okay. You continue to learn. Let me check if matrix is a keyword in C++.
And
Okay, matrix is not a keyword, so you can use it. Okay, now the matrix, Mas. The matrix need to be two-dimensional.
Sorry, how do you
like list of list, right? So how element. You do? Huh?
The element has to be an array.
Yeah. So in C++, it's actually easy to do that. You just need to define it as bracket. So in matrix itu, you define bracket.
Oh.
Ya kayak gitu, tapi you need to define it first di atas lah, nggak di situ.
Iya.
Ya, yang itu, yang in matrix itu. Nah, itu you add one more bracket.
As an array of arrays.
Yeah, but you need to specify the length. Remember, C++, you need to specify a length. And it cannot be variable. No, it's not allowed. Variable is not allowed kalau C++ array. It has to be fixed. So you need to take what is the maximum n there. Lihat di soalnya. What is the maximum n?
49.
Yeah.
So why isn't there any error for it?
Wait. Nah, itu juga 49. So you always have an array of 49 by 49 kan?
Hmm.
Yeah, and then you apa namanya? You need to take the input dulu kan? You have not taken the input. Oh, you want to set to zero ya? Yeah? You want to set to zero, is it? What are you doing in this for loop?
Does it already have the array inside?
Yeah, it's two-dimensional array. You already have it.
Oh, okay.
Nah, so you already have 49 by 49 array.
X is not equal to Y, then we have to find what matrix Y.
Very good. Yeah.
Set it to zero.
Yeah. Now, how do you set to zero? Coba Google aja. Google. Initialize. Coba ini apa? 2D array itu. Initialize two dimensional array. C++. Yeah. So there are a number of ways. Yeah, but what I want you to learn and usually what is used itu memset. So if you scroll down, ada one of the answers are actually using memset. Itu memset. Yeah. Memset. So what is memset? Memset means memory set. So setting the value of the memory. Remember kalau array itu kan just, you know, it's like blocks of memory.
Yeah.
Each cell is for integer. For your case, is for integer, right? So integer. which means it's a 32-bit, right? 32-bit memory for one integer. 32-bit memory for one integer. Ini apa? 49, and then another 49, and then another 49, 49 times, right? So that's what you have actually. You have like a block of memory, 49 by 49. Each item in the 49 by 49 itu integer kan? Yeah. So the command is, so if you can type below it, memset, ya kan? The name of the array. What is the name of your array? Matrix, ya? Comma. What do you want to set it to? You want to set it to zero, right? Size of meaning the size of the each item itu. So size of integer, kan? Because you are each one of them. No, you don't need to do that. You just say integer aja. Yeah. Size of integer, right? Size of integer. How many times how many gitu?
Times n.
Ada how many pieces gitu? Times n, correct. And this will set for the address of the matrix array n times n, n times n of integer block. It will set everything to be zero. That's what it means. It's a memory block and it set everything to be zero. Gitu.
Yeah.
Doesn't work. What happened? No. Oh, it's not n by n lah. Sorry. What am I talking about? Your memory size, remember, is not n by n. Okay, good. Now you are getting there. Now it's just logic bug sekarang. So what is wrong there? Oh yeah, I know lah. You see your answer there? What do you notice from your answer on from your output? What do you think could be the problem? No, it's not. Because it's symmetrical, so even if you reverse, it's the same thing, right? It's symmetrical, so. Look at the way you read the input. And look at the problem. What is your input? Yes, very good. Yeah, so this is another, you know, well, it's actually, it happens not just in C++ ya. Nggak cuma di C++, di anywhere. Kita harus hati-hati dengan apakah zero index ataukah one index. Gitu. Jadi kalau di C++ dan Python, array, list, vector, semuanya itu zero index. So you start from zero. So if kalau di sini inputnya actually countingnya from one, jadi kayak node one, node two, node three, then you need to minus one dulu kan?
Yeah.
Alright, good. Also, by the way, you don't need to do x not equal to y karena it will always be not equal, right? The input will always be not equal, so you don't really need to do that, right?
Oh, do I not?
Yeah, otherwise inputnya salah dong. Tapi ya benar, kalau in real life, karena in real life coding, we cannot assume input will always be correct. So yeah. Needs to include string aja coba, nggak usah si string juga, string doang bisa nggak? Actually memset kok si string ya. Bentar, memset, Google aja memset include.
Nah, they say you need to include si string in C++.
Oh, si string ya. Mem set. String doang bisa kayaknya. String doang coba. Coba string doang. Ya, yang second one aja yang easier ya.
Mem set.
Bentar, yang atas apa? Atas apa?
Si string.
String juga ya. Oke, ya udahlah si string. Yeah, this kind of include problems you won't have if you use the bits / std C++ itu yang tadi malam kita lihat kan. Tapi it's a good lesson for you to learn to know apa every function itu adanya di mana gitu. Nah, kalau sekarang kan aku jadi tahu kalau memset adanya di si string gitu. And I actually think string juga bisa. Coba edit answer-nya bisa enggak? Di sini di on the screen aja. Bisa kan? Edit. Coba string doang gitu bisa enggak? Submit again. Ya, yeah, resubmit. Oke, oke. Harus si string ya, oke. Okay. I'm also learning sekarang. Enggak ada, berarti harus si string. So, si string resubmit. Right, 100, good. Okay, so you learn new things sekarang ya. One more, satu lagi yang baru yang kamu pelajari tadi itu adjacency matrix. Nah, adjacency matrix itu useful untuk graph mas, graph theory, graph problems. Jadi kayak misalnya gini, kamu soalnya imagine ada soal seperti ini ya. Kamu dikasih N cities, and then dikasih oh dari this city to this city ada road connecting it gitu, it's connected. And then kayak tadi adjacency matrix tadi kan connected, roadnya connected. And then pertanyaannya gini, given two cities, can you tell whether you can go from that city to the other city? Are they connected or not? Nah. Gitu. Jadi misalnya okay, Jakarta ke Bandung, you have road connecting it. Bandung ke Semarang ada road connecting it. Semarang ke Tuban ada road connecting it. Tuban ke Surabaya ada road connecting it. Surabaya ke Gresik ada road connecting it. Terus the input ask Bandung Gresik, can you go from Bandung to Gresik? Then the answer is yes, you can. But let's say ada satu lagi gitu kan. Denpasar, Gianyar, ada road connecting it. Gianyar, Ubud, ada road connecting it gitu ya. Tapi there's no road connecting from any of Jakarta, Surabaya to any of Denpasar, Gianyar, Ubud gitu. So then the answer should be, kalau pertanyaannya Semarang, Ubud, no, cannot. And you know why? Because they are in separate island gitu. There is no road, there is no bridge. Kalau Denpasar kan di Bali, so there is no road connecting it. Denpasar di Bali, terus Jakarta sampai Gresik tadi itu kan di Jawa.
Yes.
Nah, this one looks easy ya. You know soal ini mas, soal kayak gini mas, itu dulu ayah pertama kali kerjain itu kuliah tahun pertama, introduction to programming apa ya, SC 101 kalau nggak salah 101 itu the course number was 101. So it's like the very first thing we learn di computer engineering. Introduction to programming with C. Jadi dulu itu pakai C, bukan C++. C. Itu very frustrating itu. It's all about pointer. Pusing. Tapi anyway, ya belajar ini, belajar printing ini. Soal lab apa? Soal kuisnya itu kayak gini, suruh print pattern gitu. Programming 101.
Then after the space.
Why is it 3? What is 3 minus A? What does 3 minus A mean?
You need 3 spaces for the first one. 1, 2, 3.
Why is it 3? Why 3 spaces?
Because the radius is 4. And the 4 includes the middle.
Yeah. So it's not 3, right? No, it's not 4 either. It's 4, it's 3 only because the input is
okay. Okay, understand. A equal to 1.
Okay, very good.
Asterisk.
Yeah, sekarang print the asterisk for how many times?
Zero. Okay, smaller than 1 + A × 2.
Okay, very good.
Yep. Asterisk. Then here new line. Then if the A reaches the middle, one, two, three.
Again, you're making the same mistake.
-1.
Whenever you write a fixed number, you need to be suspicious of yourself. Why fixed number? Why constant? Is it really constant in all test cases? Is it really constant?
If A equals to n minus 1. I just create a bool.
What do you want to do here?
I want if C is true, then I increase A, but if C is false, I decrease A. Because you have to make it smaller.
But your for loop is only for n times, no? So you're only printing n lines. You either do it that way or you know there's an easier way. You split, can you split this diamond into two triangles? Will it be easier that way?
It's not two equal triangles.
Yeah, doesn't matter, right? You make the two printing triangles to be not equal, so not a problem also. I'm just giving you options. Yeah, you can also do it this way lah.
I want to do it
Yeah, yeah, do it this way. So you don't need to write two for duplicate for loops, yeah.
I have to repeat the whole thing.
Yeah, you don't want to repeat the whole thing, yes. Okay.
Well, it's left plus.
Very good. Okay, very good.
Ah, that's all right.
Very good, first try, ya. Huh? Yeah, very good, very good.
And there may be something I'm missing because it's not the same compiler.
I think this is correct. I think you will get it accepted.
Maybe. Yay.
Yeah, very good. Actually, the way you think itu quite similar with the way I think itu. I would also do the same. I think too lazy to write the for loops, and just use a boolean. Sometimes it's risky because if your boolean logic is not correct, then you will get it wrong.
Everything wrong. Jiko has just finished marking exam scripts and she's going to total the score for each reference group. However, he's lazy to count the total amount of questions in the script itself. He asked you to write a program for him to find out the total score of each exam script by just typing individual scores for each question into the program. And one marks the end of the scores. While oh, wait, I could engine. N equals 0. While N not equal minus 1, G in N. T plus equal N. T out. Oh, then if I input, then N will become minus 1.
Okay, nice. What was the problem? Apa Ayah bahkan nggak tahu ini problemnya apa ini?
Disuruh apa? Just finding the total sum except minus 1.
Oh. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
We just wondering how come is
one. Your while n not equal to minus 1 itu bisa jalan karena you initialize it to 0 ya. Okay. Good. Okay, next problem.
X square. A program should write to the.
Check check is it square number or not ya. Apakah itu bilangan kuadrat atau enggak? Cek apakah itu bilangan kuadrat sempurna atau enggak. Gimana? What will you do?
4 What's the biggest A? 10 million.
10 million. Small, 10 million is small. Berarti maksimalnya berapa? Kalau inputnya itu maksimal 10 juta, berarti square number-nya apa ya? The number being square yang dikuadratkan, bilangan yang dikuadratkan maksimal berapa? Very small, right? Kalau 1000 berapa? 1000 square berapa?
1000 square is 1 million.
1 million 1 juta, right? So 10,000, 10,000 square berapa?
100 million.
Yeah, 100 million. So it's between 1000 and 10,000. It's really small actually, kan? Actually it's around 3000 something, kan? Karena 3000 square berapa?
9 million.
9 million kan. Yeah. So it's around 3000 something, kan? So it's very small actually. Kalau mau check one by one juga okay. No problem. You can do it that way. Atau you can also do square root, kan? Like even more square root itu you do. Ya, yeah, Google aja coba. You need to learn juga, kan? Include kalau no, square root kita aja, square root.
Square root.
QRT.
Mathematics, square root of x plus the square root x in C program. Double square root double x, root square root root x, long double square root long double x, double square root d x.
So you can just do it right and convert to integer. Convert it to integer.
But if it's not an integer, then.
So what happen when? Coba aja. You try aja coba. You learn by trying aja.
Convert double to int.
So you sama kayak Python ini sebetulnya, you just need to put int bracket.
Oh, okay. Then
just need to do int bracket. You know what happened, right? So if let's say your square root, let's say itu not an exact number, kayak misalnya square root of 10. What is square root of 10?
3.333333333333.
Yeah, what will happen if you do int square root of 10? What will you get?
3.
Yeah, good.
Oh, I make it an int and then I square it and I see if it's equal.
Easy, right?
Int and cin and then if okay, so first I get the square root. How do I get the square root again? I have to include cmath.
Oh, okay.
And then I take the root of n, then int, then I square it. Square root Wow. I think I can just time sheet itself. Time in square root n equal to n equal to n, then we have this. L no. Ding ding. Ding ding. Ding ding. Wait, actually, there's a 64. I am the 833,077 person to submit. Wow. Hello World X.
Yes. Kategori
Google. Sounds easy. The catch is your score. It's determined by the number of characters in the code. It's zero. Your output is hello world. You'll obtain points based on your length of your source code, number of characters including spaces and end lines.
You need to make it as short as possible.
My code?
Mm-mm.
Okay. I need to use bits. And yeah. I cannot use... wait, I'm gonna make it as short.
this is fun.
I'm gonna make it normal first and then make it shorter. Include IO stream using namespace std int name. What's that called? Yup. Does it have to
No.
Have to enter?
No.
Don't have to enter?
Don't have. Coba, sampai dulu coba.
No. I have to make it shorter.
No, sampai dulu. Test dulu how much score you get if just doing this way.
Okay. Let's see. Hello World X, let's see, baby. Check this submit. 32.73 points.
Okay, now you edit.
No, I commit it first. You say the normal way.
Okay.
Hello world. X. The normal way. Then I make it as short as possible. I guess
yes, very good. And actually you don't need int. In your main, you don't need int. Yeah, it will just default to void. I think, yeah, it will do that way. Coba. Does it compile? Does it run? Yeah.
Of course not.
Oh, yet. You still need, yeah. Okay, int. Int. Put an int. Put an int. You still need int. Int main. You still need int. coba backspace, put it up. Make it into one line. Ya, coba. Oh, enggak dia. Ya. Oh, masih error ya, enggak boleh ya. You need to space, is it? Okay, then never mind. Just put an enter lah, doesn't matter. Enter is also just one character, right? So it's the same. Yeah.
When I do this, I make it shorter.
Don't think it. Coba, mau enggak?
It works. It actually works.
Yeah. Okay. Coba submit ini. How much score you get with this one?
Do I even need this?
Yeah. No, colon is a must. It tells the compiler when to stop.
Wrong one.
This is very funny, yeah.
Is there anyone who got 100? I got 80.
Very good, 80, not so bad. Okay, how do we reduce this further? Okay, now sekarang gini, std dash dash itu, will it be shorter if you use printf? Coba, if you use printf, is it shorter?
Printf.
Looks shorter, right? Coba, does it work, run?
Oh.
Ya, coba submit. Do you get the increase of
the std dot dot c. Yeah, it should be more, just a little more. Yeah, 85.45.
Okay, very good, getting close. Now the last thing, do you need to include IO stream for printf? I actually don't know. You want to Google it?
Printf
itu include-nya apa? Printf include juga.
Include.
Because I think printf standard. Oh, CSTDIO. CSTDIO. Okay, coba.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, you still need it.
Include CSTDIO.
Okay, coba test.
Pass.
Submit. How many characters do you have here? Yeah. Okay, just submit dulu. I think you reduce like a few characters kan just now. This is a funny problem, yeah. The shortest code to make a
world. 89.09.
Okay, what else can we reduce?
Is it necessary to put min?
Yeah, it's a must.
Wow. Okay, number of characters smaller than or equal to 45.
How many more characters do you need to reduce? Can you count your characters? How many characters are there?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51.
So you need to remove how many more characters?
Six. At least six.
Six more characters, yeah. Yeah, I think it's definitely on the include. Is there a way to reduce that?
output C plus plus without include.
Someone actually asked the question. Yeah, you're not the first one. Stack Overflow, yeah, Stack Overflow is always.
Is that true? It's even longer.
Okay, you know what?
No.
We can cheat here. Google shortest C++ to Hello World. I think this is a well-known problem. I should be.
C++ to Hello World.
Oh my god. Puts. There is puts. Coba, what is the include for puts? I didn't know puts. I never know puts.
Include puts. C++. CSTDO.
Okay, same. Coba run. Does it work? Run.
Yeah, it works.
How much did you reduce? Yeah, print F puts
PRIN 2. I reduce 2. I reduce 2.
Sampai dulu. You increase your score dulu. This is a funny problem. How to print C++ in the shortest possible way. Oh my god.
Yay, I got 92.
2.73, not bad. How can we get to 100 now? Okay, how many more characters? 4 more, yeah?
4 more. How was it 4? Yeah, it's 4.
Oh my god. Coba, Quora tadi. Oh, you can just do error. It's interesting.
Yeah, but those also have overhead to define main and include. It's another way that avoids all that.
Just say error. You gotta be kidding me. Does it really work? Wanna try that? No, it's like
error. Hello. World.
No, this looks like you don't even need the like the whole file is just. Yeah, just that. Can you try? Run? Try submit, coba. Does it really work? Just submit, coba. You don't need semicolon. You don't need semicolon. Coba. Just submit aja. Because it's actually not a program, kan? It's just an error message. Because it's actually not a program, it's telling the compiler to just. Oh, okay. Yeah.
Hashtag error C++.
Error directive, nah itu coba. Ya itu, error itu tadi. Error message itu.
It causes the compiler to output the error message.
Yeah. But yeah, maybe not. I think it's the wrong way. Can you just undo and revert your code back to the original? Yeah. Okay, so this is so far your best solution, kan? We need to reduce 4 more characters.
Equal. What? That was equal.
Oh wow, that's interesting. So you don't even need to. What is 42 there? What is that number 42? It looks like you need 42. Where is why 10? 42, right? Where is 42? Nah.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it doesn't work. Coba cari lagi. Okay, this is interesting. Shortest C++ hello world.
Code Golf Tech Exchange.
Smallest hero world, C++. Shortest way to print C++. Ada YouTube video segala tuh.
We are called, so this is our output from our output.
But it's not even that short. Yours is much, much shorter. Video is not that short at all.
So this is as shown.
It's not that short. This question.
I want to see one. If anyone has ever made 100%, 100 points.
Can we see? Oh, we can see others, is it?
But you can't.
Oh, someone have 100. Can we take a look at his submission?
You can't see his code. You can only see analysis mode.
Okay, someone. So it is possible, yeah? Okay. But we know that it is possible, right?
Yeah. We know it's possible.
How? Is there a way to shorten the include?
Short include short include. What is the abbreviation for include? Not this. C++. My hands. Shortest way to ring. C++. So I'll put the input here. The shortest code that works.
No, that's not shortest. Yours is already much shorter than that. Oh my god, I really don't know what to. Okay, let's
shortest way to output. Fastest way to output. No. Shortest way. No, not this. I don't know.
Coba compile your code dulu, Mas. Run your test cases just to make sure your latest file is not.
Yeah.
So I don't know actually. You wanna Google some more or you wanna leave this behind?
I don't know. Hello, Portus. Good. Hello world. Hello. Yes. C++ hello world program. Nope. I don't know. I really don't know. Anybody else got 100? No. Huh? What? How
did Arian, you... it's Arian.
Yeah, how come I don't think... I don't know how to do. Okay, let's see.
I don't know how.
How do you include C++? Huh? No. Yeah, if this was Python, I would create another file and then I import that file and then I just done. Well, then it will just be there. Nice, you want to. Include libraries list. A list of open source C++ libraries.
Yeah, I need to find a shorter library, right? Is there like IO, include IO gitu? Maybe include CSTDIO itu 6 characters ya?
Yeah, 6. Let me get.
Yeah, I don't know. Is there such thing as IO? No, there is no IO.
There is IOS.
Oh lah, kalau nggak ada, nggak ada lah.
Let's IOS.
I don't think it. Coba try. Oh, yeah, I don't think it is.
IOS. No, what? I stream, O stream, IO.
Okay, Mas, kita makan dulu aja yuk. Kita stop dulu makan dulu.
Amazing.
I have tweeted. Let's see if then apa later someone will help answer how to. But yeah, this is already very good. You berapa? What is your score? 90 berapa?
92.73
is your score ya. Okay.
Yeah.
That's good. Let's let's break dulu. Let's makan dulu. Nanti kita continue lagi.
You have to try it. Oh. Oh okay. I don't.
All right.
Yes, 92.73.
Yeah, 92.73.
Okay.